We will solve the problem 2.58 of ERODO. There are some concepts which are useful. The mechanism given here is there are two cylinders which are similar. Mass is M of same mass of each cylinder, and let the radius be R, which will also be same for both the cylinders. Moment of inertia I will be mr square upon 2. Now what we have to find out is the cylinder is, they are connected to each other by two strings, and strings are rolled on the cylinder. So what will happen is when we release this lower cylinder, if you hold it, no movement takes place. Once you release it, it will fall down, and when it is falling down, there is tension on the string, because of which there is rotation in this cylinder and this cylinder. We don't know what is the rotation. Let us see how to derive the relationship between the rotations of the two cylinder and the tension in the each string. Let T be the tension in each string, and total tension would be T dash B twice T. Let us draw a side diagram. This is the upper cylinder, which is fixed, but it can rotate on its axis. The lower cylinder can both rotate, and also there is a translational motion. Let this be the total tension, T dash, which is twice T. Now, what is happening here? We need to understand certain concepts. One is that this cylinder has only rolling rotational motion, and there will be angular acceleration alpha. This I alpha would be equal to T dash R. This is very simple. Tension will apply torque, and torque is equal to I alpha. This is torque. I is M R square upon 2 is equal to T dash R into alpha. This alpha can also be written in terms of the acceleration of the string. Let us take this point A. At this point, the acceleration would be A, or this point means the acceleration of the string, which is at this moment touching the surface. It is moving down, string is moving down. So this point will move down with an acceleration A is equal to R alpha. So we can write alpha is A upon R. So this relationship comes to M A upon 2 is equal to T dash. This is one relationship which we have got. Now let us take the lower cylinder now, and it is having both the rotational and the linear motion, the vertical motion, and let the rotational acceleration be alpha dash, and take this as a frame of reference, and just imagine that this frame of reference is attached to a string. There is no weight of the frame of reference, only an imaginary reference frame which is attached to the string. String points are moving down with this acceleration, so this reference frame is also coming down with acceleration A. Let the acceleration of center of mass be A dash in the reference frame. Please note, A dash is not the absolute acceleration, only the acceleration, linear acceleration in this reference frame. So whenever there is acceleration of the reference frame also, you have to take a pseudo force in the opposite direction. Since we are considering this frame is moving with acceleration A, the mass inside this frame will experience a pseudo force MA in the opposite direction of A, that is upwards. What is the downward force? Is mg. Let us write the relationship for this A dash. M A dash would be equal to mg minus m A minus T. MA and T are both in upward direction and G is downwards. A dash we have taken downwards, that is with reference frame. So this is the relationship which comes. This is one relationship, this is another relationship. Now just see that the string, this cylinder is moving, is rolling with an acceleration alpha along the center of mass. So the acceleration of any point on the string would be A dash would be equal to alpha dash r. If alpha dash is the angular acceleration, A dash would be alpha dash r, where A dash is the acceleration of the center of mass relative to the string. String we are considering, this relative to the frame of reference, which will also be relative to the string, because string we are considering is attached here to the imaginary frame of reference. So A dash will then be equal to alpha dash r. Now apply the formula for the rotational motion. The torque acting on this about the center of mass is T dash r. This would be equal to I alpha dash, and I is m r square upon 2 into alpha dash. Alpha dash is A dash upon r. So T dash r is equal to m r square upon 2 A dash upon r. So it becomes T dash is equal to M A dash upon 2. T dash is equal to M A dash upon 2, and T dash was also equal to M A upon 2. So it shows that A dash is equal to A. Please note, A dash is not the absolute acceleration. It is the acceleration of the center of mass in this reference frame. So A dash is equal to A. Put the value of A dash here and also T here. So we get M A is equal to M G minus M A minus T is M A upon 2 A upon 2. These two get added and it becomes minus 3 upon 2. Bring it on this side, so it becomes 5 m a upon 2 is equal to m g. So a is equal to, a would be equal to twice g upon 5. What is the value of T dash? T dash is MA upon 2. So T dash is MG upon 5. What is T dash relationship with tension in each string? T dash is equal to twice T. So T is equal to T dash upon 2. So T in each string is MG upon 10. This is the answer to the problem. So just keep few things in mind while doing such problems. When there is a case where cylinder is there and it is rotating on its axis, also moving down, and the string itself is moving because the upper cylinder is also rotating. Unlike a situation where the string was fixed, then the reference frame was fixed. Had the string been fixed to, like in this case, cylinder is fixed, suppose this string was fixed directly there, so then the reference frame was stationary. But here the string is attached to the cylinder and string points are moving with an acceleration a, so that is why we took this frame of reference moving with acceleration a, and the acceleration for this mass is to be taken a dash in reference to this frame. So that is all on this problem. Thank you.